Hello, my name is Babette, and welcome to book two of Babette's Quick Start Guide to Theory for Fiddlers. Welcome back. I'm so happy to see you here. Book two is a continuation of book one, building on those things that we've already learned. And we're going to start with the major scales. So the title of the first lesson is Major Scales, Step 2. And first we're going to review a couple of the things that we learned in book one. For example, what is the major scale finger pattern? Well, that is whole step, half step, whole step, whole step, whole step, half step. Remember also that W means whole step and H means half step. And very important is that two half steps make a whole step. It's also very important to note that this same finger pattern, the same major scale finger pattern, is used for all 12 of the major keys. Now, what are those 12 major keys? Well, remember the circle of fifths. And going around the circle of fifths are those 12 major keys. So let's review them. We start with the strings of our violin. G, D, A, and E. And then we learned that B is the fifth of E. So now we have five of them. The very next key is the first sharp, which is F sharp. F sharp is also known as G flat. The one following that is C sharp, also known as D flat. Now remember, when we studied flats, that there was a word that we could use to help us remember those flats, and that word was bead. B-E-A-D, or better, B-flat, E-flat, A-flat, and D-flat. And I just said D-flat. So now we just want to spell D-flat backwards, and that will give us four more of those keys. D-flat, A-flat, E-flat, and B-flat. And then we go to F and C. In book one, we learned about one octave major scales, and we learned those that started on the open strings, G, D, and A. Now we're going to learn about one octave major scales that start by using a finger, the first finger, the second finger, or the third finger. The most important thing to remember here is this. It doesn't matter what finger or what string you start a scale on. The major scale finger pattern is the same. And now, let's do some examples of those scales. I hope you got your violins out so you can play along with me as I explain what we're doing. We're starting with the A major scale. And if you recall, in book one, we played that A major scale starting on the open A string. But now, we're going to play an A major scale starting with the first finger on the G string. So, let's start by playing that A, the first finger on the G string. Now you're going to want to go a whole step to your second finger B. Now another whole step to your third finger C sharp, and this third finger is going to be in the high position. Now we'll do a half step to your fourth finger D, or you can play an open D. Now we'll have another whole step to your first finger E on the D string. A whole step to your second finger F sharp. A whole step to your third finger G sharp. And that's also in the high position. And a half step to your fourth finger A. Now we're going to take a look at the F major scale. Before we start, I want to give you a little hint that may help you remember that the whole steps and half steps are between two notes and not the notes themselves. Because often I have a student that says whole step when they play the first note. No, the whole step is between the first note and the second note. So one helpful little hint that I've used in the past is saying a whole step up to the next note. And I will say that as we go over this F major scale. So let's begin by placing our second finger on the D string in the low position to play F. And then we have a whole step up to our third finger G. Whole step up to fourth finger A, or you can play an open A. And we have a half step up to first finger B flat, and that is in the low position, very close to the nut of your violin. Then we have a whole step up to the second finger C, which is also in a low position. A whole step up to third finger D. A whole step up to fourth finger E, or you can play your open E. And then a half step up to your first finger F, which is in a low position on your E string. And now let's take a look at our C major scale. And we're going to start that scale on the G string with our third finger in the normal position. Then we're going to play a whole step up to fourth finger D, or you can play the open D string. Then we're going to go a whole step up to our first finger E, which is on the D string. Then a half step to our second finger F, and that's going to be in the low position. Then a whole step up to third finger G, a whole step up to fourth finger A, or you can play open A. Then a whole step up to the first finger B on the A string, and we'll finish with a half step up to the second finger C, and that will be in a low position. And one more time, let me stress that it does not matter what finger or what string you start the major scale on. The finger pattern is always the same. And that pattern is whole step, whole step, half step, whole step, whole step, whole step, half step. Okay, let's take a look at our worksheet on major scale step 2. Question 1. You have now learned two ways to play a 1 octave A major scale. You can either start the scale on the G string, or you can start the scale on the A string. When you start the scale on the G string, are your first fingers in the same position as they were when you started the scale on the A string? And that answer is yes. What about your second fingers? Are they still in the same position? And that answer is yes. Your third fingers, are they still in the same position? And that answer is no. Question 2. What is a helpful way of saying the intervals? You can say whole step up to or half step up to. Question 3. Is it your finger position or the note interval that stays the same no matter what major scale you are playing? It is the note interval that stays the same no matter what major scale you are playing. And now for the review questions. Question 4. What is the major scale pattern? That pattern is whole step, half step, whole step, whole step, whole step, half step. Question 5. You are going to play a song in the key of F. How many sharps are there? How many sharps are there in the key of F? There are no sharps in the key of F. What about flats? Are there flats in the key of F? Yes, there is one flat. And what is it? The first flat is B flat. Question 6. What is the number of the most important note in the scale? That number is 1. And what is another word for that note? That word would be tonic. And question 7. What does 1, 4, 5 refer to? Well, that refers to a common chord progression that contains the 1 chord, the 4 chord, and the 5 chord. Thank you for following along with me this first lesson in Book 2. I look forward to seeing you again for the next lesson. Thank you. Thank you.